So we have 6:31 to go in the third quarter. Cal Poly is up 33-27 on UC Riverside. And we have UNLV. They were up 27-13 after their hot start in the first. They've cooled off a little bit. Nevada's favored now, but also UNLV's favored on Nevada too. And UNLV limited them even more. That's 40-17. UNLV blowing out Nevada. UNLV proving why they are worthy of winning the Mountain West. And you know, becoming like a good high seed in like March Madness if they win their conference tournament. I mean, like, even if they don't, they beat Oklahoma, they beat Arizona, they lost to Seton Hall by 30, but they had that one upset in New Mexico. But after that, they've been playing like really solid, you know. And, you know, maybe they could reach top 25th in the country. Yeah, again, because Princeton, you know, fell to Columbia. Or maybe Fairfield might make it. We'll see, maybe Fairfield's true. But anyways, so let's do that. Let's go to the Big West, where Cal Poly is up 33-27 at UC Riverside, with 6:15 to go in quarter number 3. It looks like it's just seeing more family and friends are attending, but there might be a few students at the game. Or maybe people at home. You know, they want to watch both the men and the women play. So they're, at home watching both, they're playing both at the same time. You know, some do it where the men play at the same time the women play. But one plays at the, one plays at home, and plays on the road, but the same two teams, playing.
Who comes, loops it to Moderons. And the baby hook off the mark. Battle for the rebound is claimed by Borland.
Mustangs, just like they have throughout the year, the number one shooting offense, shooting relatively well, not as good as we expect, but relatively well. It's amazing. UC Riverside with all the mistakes. It's a two-score ball game.
And here's Borland with a tough drive. Off glass right at Webster. Sydney Borland, she's up to 8 points. Despite the slow start by Cal Poly, Webster off from three. The Highlanders unable to take advantage of those first 4 minutes. And Cal Poly leading by 8 after they led by 10 at the break. A lot of dribbling there from Carter. Fortunate bounce. It goes right to Shaw. And she will reset it here.
Yeah, tough night for Jordan Webster. She's 2 for 9. The rest of the team is 10 for 21. Almost 50%. That, to me, is part of it, too, You see Riverside struggling to score when your number one scorer is not playing well.
Sydney Richards with her first bucket, the lead back up to 10. At times this year, the third quarter has been the money quarter for Jordan Webster. But just the 4 points. Blocking foul against Richards as Jordan Marshall was driving inside. It'll be UC Riverside basketball when we return. Cal Poly going for the season sweep of the Highlanders.
Tables. But last week, I built a field hospital.
I stopped 1,000 attackers.
And a natural disaster.
Well, I go to school full-time while I work full-time.
The greater the challenge, the stronger we become.
You're freezing me. That means...
Yes, there's a better chicken wing. Popeyes.
The Sailor Man?
No, the chicken place.
Crispy, juicy. What else have we done?
I mean, man, there's a lot. There's a lot's been going on.
Turn down for what?
Here we go.
Make it stop! Make it stop!
Two dogs in one? Impossible!
A pack for your fanny?
Genius!
You're crazy.
Come to Papa!
We did it!
The wait is over. Popeyes finally has wings.
Love that chicken from Popeyes!
Pure Leaf crafts real brewed iced tea using the highest quality tea leaves without any artificial flavors. Nothing that doesn't make our tea better. Pure Leaf iced tea. Real variety, real brewed.
We're the Ghostbusters.
It's our job to protect the city.
All right, that was cool.
We might be looking at an army of ghosts.
We're gonna need all the help we can get.
Melnitz in uniform, yeah.
Okay, but now let's go to Fox Sports 1, where UNLV is leading Nevada 45-20.
First half. So, you know, the play that UNLV just ran right now is called Pistol. And the guard can pass it to the player on the wing. She can drive off of it. Then you get a fade screen from the big. It's a beautiful play. They use it in college. They use it in the W. They use it in the NBA.
13 now for Desiree Young. Nevada possession in the final minute. Bodies on the deck, no whistle. And Roden from the corner airballs it. Rebound Young. He now has 8 rebounds. Razo Frescas.
Tough when you're a coach and you're seeing this because you know your team has been playing better, but you're playing against, you know, the best in your conference right now.
Too tall on that inside look for Lathrop. Again, this is a Nevada team that, as we mentioned, 8-6 in the Mountain West. This is not some bottom-dwelling team in the standings. This is just a tour de force from the Lady Rebels.
And you know, sometimes, you know, styles make fights, and sometimes you don't match up with your opponent in certain areas on the floor, and they're having their way offensively. They wanted to get the ball inside, they have. They wanted to push tempo, they have, and they've been really good at rebounding.
4 seconds. Kempson. Another chance before the horn. Won't go, and that maybe is the only thing that doesn't go right for UNLV in the first 20 minutes on the floor of their arch rival, Nevada Wolfpack.
And that is a blowout right now. 50-20 at half. So UNLV is just doing everything right over the Nevada rivalry and the Nevada rival. In the Mountain West. So we have, let's go back to Cal Poly and Riverside. It is a low scoring game, 37-30. But it is a lower scoring third quarter, that is. Riverside's picking up scoring in the third quarter. You know, but Cal Poly's, you know, keeping pace a little bit. They're only even outscored by 3 in the third. So let's go to Cal Poly at UC Riverside, 233. And then after this, there will be a little bit of a break. You know, possibly. At We'll see. And then we'll go back to Cal Poly Riverside when UNLV Nevada is after done up, you know, the halftime.
Earlier in the game, but we're not seeing that later in the game, that jump stop action from Bryant.
So an offensively challenged third quarter, the team's combining for just 11 points. And we've got just a little more than 2 minutes to go before the fourth. Foul here as McNicholas was trying to get a feed inside, but was bumped by Tillery. 13 foul against UCR in the quarter. The Highlanders have been able to navigate that foul trouble we've been talking about. Moderons and Sanderson still with three, and they're both currently on the bench. Haven't added to that total here in the third quarter. Nine to shoot. McNicholas probes. Moreland foul. Trailing foul there from Tillery, her second foul, this time down the floor. So free throws coming for Sydney Borland, who is a very good foul shooter in this one. She's perfect 4 of 4.
I think this is one of those cases where, you know, Brad Langston and the coaching staff is saying at some point, we just need someone who makes a play. We can do everything we can to put you in better positions, to, you know, try and create offense for you and try and make things easier. But at some point, somebody's got to step up in the ballgame here.
Sydney Borland, a San Jose native junior out of Archbishop Mitty. Great high school program there in the South Bay area.
Right.
Anya McNicholas also out of Mitty. As Borland makes two more free throws.
Who's going to step up and make a play here in the third quarter?
We've only got less than 2 minutes to go. Bryant, the jump stop, finds Stenberg, but underneath the basket, could not finish. Lichty perhaps affected it a bit. It was a nice feed from Bryant. Stenberg in traffic couldn't finish it off. It has not been a great third quarter for Cal Poly, but they can close it strong. Borland, too much on it off the glass. And an offensive foul. Bryant running over McNicholas.
I don't think I've seen many games in the Big West this year played better defensively than Cal Poly. You put this on a reel and send the guys that are trying to make it. Picture perfect defense today by Cal Poly.
I say Bryant used the elbow there and trying to get some separation. Richards down the alley. Offensive rebound, Ackerman, and she puts it up and in. Mustangs have matched their largest lead of the game. Bryant inside, and it's going the other way. Another offensive foul against UCR and Matea Bryant. Those are only her two fouls all game that we have just seen, but she's going to check out here. Well, UC Riverside, they had such an opportunity in this quarter, but they're now trailing by more than they were at halftime.
I had mentioned, you know, quit thinking so much going into the locker room. 8 assists, 8 turnovers, just a lot of sloppy plays off the dribble. Well, the third quarter was even worse. UCR had 5 turnovers, only 1 assist, and I can't even remember that 1 assist. It seems every possession the Highlanders are just trying to create a little too much. And it's been that sort of night. I mean, 2-on-1, but she stepped out of bounds.
Yeah, Stenberg on the sideline and generating that steal.
Is that's the best look they've had all night. A 2-on-1, and the defense is turning around. Tough break.
And they say she had full possession, so it's a full 30-second shot clock here for Cal Poly, and they can wind this clock down if they so choose.
I'd be shocked if they didn't.
McNicholas probing here. Lichty open. Offensive rebound. Marshall deflected it up in the air. And Walters brings it forward. Jackson. And Ackerman's got a rebound. She now has a double-double with 14 points to go along with 10 rebounds. Final seconds. McNicholas. Hoist.
And Cal Poly takes a 41-30 lead into the fourth quarter. on the road at Riverside. And an FS one, 50-20, UNLV over Nevada. So we'll take a little break here. And when UNLV at Nevada is in the third quarter, we'll go to Cal Poly at Riverside for the rest. For that one.